and a very warm welcome to Life in Style. Well, it's an Oscar biggies weekend at the box office. The King's Speech and Black Swan have both released in India today. Now, I don't think you need a review to go watch those films. So what we're doing is refreshing your memory about what these films are about. And we also tell you about a third film that's new at the box office.
The King's Speech and Black Swan, two Academy Award heavyweights, hit the theatres today. The delay in release, notwithstanding the buzz around both the films, is quite strong. Black Swan. The King. While The King's Speech got Colin Firth an Oscar for portraying a stuttering King George VI, Natalie Portman also danced her way to the top spot of a nuanced and complex performance as a troubled ballet performer in Black Swan. The King's Speech, amongst others, also picked up the Best Film Award. All in all, you don't have much choice. You can't just watch one and skip the other.
That is St. Edward's.
But if, like us, you two are reeling under the Oscar mania, we suggest you look at the third film that also released today, The Way Back. With an exciting cast comprising of Jim Sturgis, Ed Harris and Colin Farrell, The Way Back is essentially a prison break film where a group of political prisoners from Poland, Yugoslavia, Latvia and America lodged at a Siberian forced labor camp during the Second World War stage a dramatic escape. It's not really the escape itself that's dramatic, but what happens thereafter.
Run!
Braving Siberian snowstorms, crossing into Mongolia, traversing the Gobi Desert, scaling the Himalayas, mind you, walking all the way, the group, or rather half the group in the end, finally enters India. The film essentially dramatizes the experiences of millions of people who got crushed between the horrors of Nazi Germany and Soviet Russia, those who either ended up at Hitler's concentration camps or Stalin's gulag.
Can you swim?
The Way Back is packed with solid performances and a decent screenplay, though there isn't much of a story here. The credits say it's inspired by a book, and the book in question, an allegedly autobiographical account of the escape. The Long Walk has proven to be not quite autobiographical, so there you go. In case you arrive late to the theatre and see what looks like a Nat Geo promo or a Johnny Walker Keep Walking ad, settle down fast, for you're late by a good 20 minutes.
So it's here too.
So even though The Way Back may not be a bad film to catch, the Oscar winners are likely to steal the show at the box office this weekend. On to something that's picking up speed as a leisure activity in India's coastal towns. Leisure sailing is catching up faster than the infrastructure to support it is coming up. But international boat makers have already sensed the potential of the market, and there are many great boats for you to buy if you are interested. First up is the Monterrey, a Florida-based boat manufacturer that is known for superior designing in boats. This one's for sports enthusiasts. It's sleek, it's smooth, it also has a spacious cabin that can accommodate two people. The price of this boat? Well, that's on request only. So do remember to catch the weekend edition of Life in Style. For now though, it's time for us to pack up for the week. We hope you have a fabulous weekend. And of course, lots more coming up for you after this breather on Bloomberg UTV.